Hi friends, today we are going to be discuss a fourth lesson in a physics, that is a work power and energy. That work power and energy in that questions which are related for JEE mains and NEET will solve today. A force F bar is equal to 6 I cap minus 8 J cap Newton acts on a particle and displaces it over 4 meters along the x axis and 6 meter along the y axis. So they are saying displacement vector in indirect method. The work done during the total displacement is, so they are asking work done. Work done is equal to F bar dot S bar, but F bar is given directly. S bar is not given directly. S bar indirectly they told, the body is moving along x axis 6 meter and along x-axis 4 meter and along y-axis 6 meter is it is moving. That's why 4 I cap plus 6 J cap you can take. So same technique what we followed we can follow. What's the solution? F bar dot S bar is equal to 6 I minus 8 J int dot 4 I plus 6 J. Multiply I component and JJ component, add them. So 6 into 4, 24. Minus 8 into 6, minus 48. 24 minus 48 gives, it's a minus 24 joules. So here, work done is negative. The negative work done is going on over here. Which option is correct? Option C is the correct option. Got it? Shall we go to next question? A shot is fired at 30 degrees with the vertical from a point on the ground with kinetic energy K. If air resistance is ignored, the kinetic energy at the top of the trajectory is, the option is 3k by 4, k by 2, k by 4. How to solve this? Now, a projectile it is like. Now, a body is projected with a velocity u by making an angle theta with a horizontal we can take. But he given theta is this one, this you can take as theta dash. Theta dash is equal to 90 minus theta you can take, given theta is equal to 30 degrees. Therefore, 90 minus 30 gives 60 degrees will be the theta dash or required theta. Got it? So now, it's going in a projectile path. So now, here ux equal to u cos theta dash. What is the kinetic energy? Initial kinetic energy k equal to ke1. That is equal to k initial equal to ke1 equal to k. That equal to half m into u square. And kinetic energy final is the final at the topmost height is equal to ke2. Ke2 is taken as half into m into ux square. That means that is taken as half m into ux square means u square cos square theta dash means 60. That it will come. What is the cos 60 value? 1 by 2. So cos square 60 means 1 by 4 you will get half m u square into 1 by 4 you can take. Now, what is that k final? K final is equal to 1 by 2 m u square into 1 by 4. Half m u square is taken as k, so replace this one with k. That is equal to k by 4. Which option is the correct one? What's the monitor? It's a k by 4. K by 4 is the option D. Shall we go to next question? A liquid of specific gravity 0.8 is flowing in a pipe line with a speed of 2 meter per second. The kinetic energy per cubic meter of it is, they're asking kinetic energy per cubic meter. Option A, 160 joules. Option B, 1600 joules. Option C, 160.5 joules. Option D, 1.6 joules. Which option is the correct option? Here, the kinetic energy by volume we need. What is the kinetic energy? Half m v square by volume. What is the mass? Mass equal to volume into density of the liquid you can take. Therefore, half into mass volume into density of the liquid, E liquid into velocity square by volume. Can I cancel volume? Therefore, you are getting ratio as 1 by 2 e into e liquid. What you find e liquid? E liquid is equal to, or rho liquid is equal to 0.8 into e water. That 0.8 into e water value? 1000. 0.8 into 1000 you are getting. And what is the velocity they given? That is a u 2 square. Velocity 2 they given. So take that value. Therefore 1 by 2 into 800. Why? Because e water is 1000, we know that. That into 4. 2 1s are, 2 2s are. So 8 2s are 16. It will give 1600 joules will be the kinetic energy per unit volume. They're asking, what is the kinetic energy per unit volume? So kinetic energy per unit volume we are finding, that is 1600 joules we got. Have you understood? Shall we go to next question? A tank of size 10 meter, 10 meter, 10 meter is full of water and built on the ground. If G equal to 10 meter per second square, the potential energy of the water in the tank is, the given options are 5 into 10 power 7 joules, 1 into 10 power 8 joules, 5 into 10 power 4 joules, 5 into 10 power 5 joules. So tank is on the ground means, where is the center of mass of the tank? At the middle of the tank it will be. So here, potential energy is equal to mgh. H is equal to total height by 2, means 10 by 2 given as 5 meters. Mass of the water is equal to volume of the water into density of the water. Volume of the water is given as 10 into 10 into 10, 10 cube. Density of the water we used in the previous question, that is 10 power 3 kg per meter cube. Then total it will come as 10 power 6 mass value. So substitute over here. Potential energy is equal to 10 power 6 into G value, take it as a 10, into H value 5 we are getting. Therefore 5 into 10 power 7. So 5 into 10 power 7 joules is the potential energy stored in that body. Got it all of you? Which option is the correct option? It's a 5 into 10 power 7 joules is that potential energy. Option A is the correct option. Shall we go to next question? A spring, when compressed by 4 centimeter, has 2 joules energy stored in it. The force required extend it by 8 centimeter will be. So they are asking the force required to extend that spring. The given options are 20 newton, 2 newton, and 200 newton and 2000 newton. Which is the correct option? Potential energy U is equal to 2 joules they given, that formula half k x square. So 2 is equal to half k, x value 4 centimeter they given, centimeter convert into meter, 4 into 10 power minus 2 whole square. So 2 bring this side, 4 is equal to k into 16 we are getting, 16 into 10 power minus 4. So 4 1s are, 4 4s are. So bring this side. K is equal to 1 by 4 into 10 power minus 4. 10 power minus 4 bringing upside gives 10 power 4 by 4. So 10 power 4 by 4 is that K value we got it. That K value we are using to find out the force. F dash is equal to K into X dash. That is equal to 10 power 4 by 4. So here x dash value they given as 8 centimeter. 8 centimeter means 8 into 10 power minus 2. Therefore 4 1s are, 4 2s are. Here 10 power 4 and 10 power minus 2 gives 10 power 2. 2 into 10 power 2 gives 200 newtons is the force acting. Got it all of you? So here the force acting on that in a spring is 200 newton. Which option is the correct? Option C is the correct option. Shall we go to next question? A bullet fired into a trunk of tree loses 1 by 4 of its kinetic energy in traveling a distance of 5 centimeter before stopping it travels a further distance of 150 centimeter, 1.5 centimeter, 1.25 centimeter, 15 centimeter. Delta KE1 by delta KE2 is equal to S1 by S2. Delta KE, we got it as KE by 4. And delta KE2, we got it as 3KE by 4. That is equal to 5 centimeter by S2. So therefore, KE, KE cancel, 4, 4 cancel, gives 1 by 3. 1 by 3 is equal to 5 by S2. Bring S to this side. S2 is equal to 5, 3 is there. It will come 15. So what is the distance traveled further to stop the body? It's a 15 centimeter. Which option is the correct? It's a option D is the correct option. Shall we go to next question? A car weighing 1000 kg is going up an incline with a slope of 2 in 25 at a steady speed of 18 km per hour. If g equal to 10 meter per second square, the power of its engine is, given options are 4 kilowatts, 50 kilowatts, 625 kilowatts, 25 kilowatts. Which option is the correct? The incline plane 2 in 25 means 25 is the horizontal distance, 2 is the vertical distance, and on that incline plane body is coming down. So you can find that how much distance it is traveled, x distance it is traveled. So distance traveled x is equal to, how to find? Square root of 25 square plus 2 square by Pythagoras theorem gives approximately equal to 25.1 it will come. So distance traveled is 25.1, it will come approximately. Time, how you will find? Time equal to distance traveled by velocity. So that is 25.1 by u. Velocity we got it as 5 meter per second. If you simplify, approximately it will come 5 seconds time. Now, what is the work done? Work done is equal to change in potential energy, mgh. But they are asking power. Power is equal to work done by time taken. That is equal to mgh by t. Now, what is the mass? 1000 kg, 10 power 3. And what is the g value? 10. What is the height here in this question? 2. By, what is the time taken we got here? 5 seconds. Simplify that. 5 1s are, 5 2s are, 2 2s are 4, 4 into 10 power 3. So what is the power? 4 into 10 power 3. So 10 power 3 is taken as a kilo. So therefore it is taken as 4 kilowatts. What is the answer? 4 kilowatts. Which option is the correct option? It's a option A, 4 kilowatts. Shall we go to next question? A simple pendulum is oscillating with an angular amplitude 60 degree. If mass of bob is 50 gram, then the tension in the string at mean position is g equal to 10 meter per second square. Option A, 0.5 newton. Option B, 1 newton. Option C, 1.5 newton. Option D, 2 newton. Which option is the correct option? This is a simple pendulum hanging over here. The mass M is there, weight acting mg downwards. Tension is there, T acting upward. Clear? So when this bob is coming from 60 degree angle, so when the bob is coming from 60 degree angle means it is coming in a curved path. When it is coming in a curved path, a centrifugal force is balanced. That centrifugal force, you can take it as a mv square by L. Therefore, T is equal to mg plus mv square by L, you can take it as. So now take the values. What is the mass of the simple pendulum? They're given as a 50 grams. Then you can take first, you consider velocity. What is the velocity it is getting when it is coming from the 60 degrees? You find out v is equal to. So what is the velocity? V equal to direct formula, we know that, root of 2gh. So what is the h value? So h value, L of 1 minus cos theta. Everybody know in that simple pendulum conditions. So now, by substituting this, V equal to root of 2 G L into 1 minus cos 60, 1 by 2. 1 minus 1 by 2, 1 by 2. 2 to cancel, therefore it will come G into L V equals to. Take that one and substitute there. Therefore, T is equal to mg plus m by L into V square means G into L. LL cancel. Mg plus mg. So it will come 2mg. What is the tension? T equal to 2mg. So T equal to 2 into m means 50 grams. Grams means 10 power minus 3 kg into g value taken as 10. Then you will get it 2 into 10, 20. 20 into 50, it will give us 1000. 1000 into 10 power minus 3, 1. So it will give us 1 newton. What is the tension acting in that string? It's a 1 newton. Which option is the correct option? Was the monitor? Option B is the correct option. Shall we go to next question? A block of mass 1 kg moving with a speed of 4 meter per second collides with another block of mass 2 kg which is at rest. The lighter block comes to rest after collision. The loss in kinetic energy of the system is option A, 8 joules. Option B, 4 into 10 power minus 7 joules. Option C, 4 joules. Option D, 0 joules. How to solve this question? Law of conservation of linear momentum is m1 u1 plus m2 u2 is equal to m1 v1 plus m2 v2. So here m1 given as 1 kg and u1 given as 4 meter per second and m2 is given as 2 kg and u2 is given as 0. After collision, m1 1 kg, v1 comes 0, m2 it is a 2 kg and v2 unknown value, we can find out that v2 value. So now 1 into 4, 4, 2 into 0, 0 is equal to 1 into 0, 0, that equal to 2 into V2. 2 2's there, 4. So V2 is equal to 2 meter per second is the velocity. The velocity having by the second body is 2 meter per second. By using that you can find out the work done. Work done is equal to, or delta W is equal to half into M1 into U1 square minus half into M2 into V2 square. Therefore, half of M1 value 1 into U1 value data taken as 4 whole square minus M2 value it is taken as 2 into V2 value we got as 2 square. Therefore, 1 by 2 into 4 4s are 16 minus 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8. 16 minus 8 gives 8, 8 by 2 gives 4 we are getting. So here 8 by 2 gives 4 joules. What is the work done? Work done is 4 joules here. Which option is correct? What's the monitor? C is the correct option. Have you got it? By ending of every episode, we are going to be asked one question for the students. A ball is dropped onto a horizontal floor. It reaches a height of 144 centimeter on the first bounce and 81 centimeter on the second bounce. Then the coefficient of restitution is option A, 0, option B, 0.75, option C, 81 by 144, option D, 1. You send your correct answer to us through SMS in the format srdg-phy-04. Your option, you send that information to 888-448-6915. The first three members can get a beautiful prizes. Thank you.
Vidyadayini Residential School, KR Nagar, Harihar. Admissions open from nursery to 10th CBSE syllabus. Shrimati Radhabai D. Gopal Rao PU College. Admissions open for PUC Science and Commerce. And Vidyadayini Degree College. Admissions open for BCom and BA. Contact today 944-81-15118.